HD Local Lifestyles continues.
Charlie Stocker is here, and he is ready to take your calls. Good morning.
But first, we have a message. I just want to say, two weeks ago, or a week ago this past Saturday, I was in Owensboro.
Yes.
Girl, I was in Owensboro last, we did a PowerPoint on straw, on seed starting. Had about 70, 75 people there at the library. Had the greatest time. The people in Owensboro, fine, talked about a couple of them this last week. They wanted to know where you were. Yeah, Where's Angie? And I said to myself, okay, when I come down here again, you're going with me.
I'll go with you, Charlie.
You're going with
me. Those are my people over there.
They are. The second thing I wanted to say was Ron talked about the wind yesterday.
Yes, and it was amazing.
And I hold my breath from not cussing from the standpoint when we have winds like that, and I've got my fireplace going, and I mean I've got a good
draft in there.
When that wind comes in, all I can do is watch that smoke come into my room,
yes.
And it is so aggravating. That's all I've got
to
say.
Well, and on the third note, Marcy Hall, we have to say hi to our friend Marcy.
Okay, Marcy.
Good morning, Marcy. And now we've done our business,
okay,
and we can do business with you. Good morning, Don.
Morning, Don.
Good morning.
Good morning.
You talked earlier about pine bark beetles and what chemical to use to control it.
Yes.
And what was that? I didn't get it written down, and where to purchase it.
Okay. Really, what you want to use is mallet, which has imidacloprid in it. Mallet. And you can get it from Superior Ag at the corner of Mill Road and St. Joe in Evansville. However, there are other places that sell it. That's where I go.
And is it something you have to mix with water?
You use it as a soil dredge, and you will do one application per year, and you put it down around early April. And by putting it down early April, the roots will take up, it's systemic, the roots will take up the imidacloprid that's in the mallet, that's what you look for, mallet, and it will act as a vaccination for the pine bark beetle.
Oh, that's a good way to put it.
Mm-hmm.
Well, Mike is on the phone. Good morning, Mike.
Morning, Mike.
Good morning.
Good morning. What's your question?
I have a miniature rose bush I've been keeping alive in the house. It's been blooming greatly, but here about a month ago, it began to develop little webs on the outside of the branches.
It what?
I don't know what could this
be. What developed, Mike? Say again. What developed on it?
Some webs, like spider webs, but they're real tiny little things.
Mm-hmm. Okay, webs developed in the cold weather on
the... It was in the inside the house.
And inside the house.
Yeah, I have a little rose bush
in. I was thinking of miniature rose bush on the outside of the house, and how could the webs
form... No, it's inside. And it's developing a web type, some kind of a... And it's killing the leaves on it.
Okay, insecticidal soap. Use insecticidal soap, 2 ounces to the gallon, put it in a sprayer, and simply spray the rose, and that will take care of it. Insecticidal soap.
One time application?
Generally one time will do it, yes.
So are there little baby spiders in there? Is that what's going on?
spider mite.
Oh, spider
mite. It's a spider mite.
Well, that's incredible.
Mm-hmm. Chewing and sucking insect.
And is that product dangerous to pets?
It's totally organic.
Oh, it is.
Totally organic and totally safe to use. I won't say you can drink it, no, but insecticidal soap is an oil, and you mix it with the water, and it will take care of the, it gets in their ventricle. Their ability to breathe is taken away from them by putting the insecticidal soap down. So you suffocate them.
On that cheery note, we'll be back.
Yeah.
Give Charlie a call.